Damn. I thought it's, oh, he, oh, the men meddled. Dang it. Dang it. Fire. I only got one AP. Change. Anything I can do with one AP? Probably not. Get a bit more health. All right, midnight. Trying to figure out what we can do.
Well, we're getting our health down steadily. Basically, we just have to out endure these. Well, one is chilled, one is so warm. And the other is wet? No, he's not.
No, but I can make him...
Yeah, if you get him moist, then I can freeze both of them on my turn.
So I'm gonna have to use a scroll for that.
Oh, I've just frozen that already. Frozen. Good.
Alright. So I still got one AP.
Prepare yourself.
Fortunately, my health the way it is, I might just barely survive a hit. First off, whoop.
Get an ice on that one over there by the incarnate and... It missed!
80%, it still counts as an aim thing.
Oh god. Well, I got a frost grenade, so I'll throw that on him. Cause I guess
all right, yeah, you are up.
I am up before him. The one in front is the one by midnight here. So this is what I'll do. Frost grenade. Yeah. Oh god.
If you hit both of them, it'll freeze him again.
Unfortunately, with the one that's in front of me, I can't exactly.
Well, I get to go.
I gotta reposition myself.
And things, I get to go before the one in front of the one I just fought at, so I'll be able to attempt to freeze it.
The thing is that I can't hit the one in the back because the one in front is blocking it physically.
Okay.
So I need to move. And then throw my frost. Okay. Totem and keep buffing your incarnate. Oh, you're using an ice scroll, okay.
Oh yeah, I do have two ice fan scrolls, I just realized.
They're good little tools.
Especially we need to freeze several.
Yep. Am I frozen?
Both.
Okay, good. Both are?
Very good.
Alright, so that means I'm gonna get my incarnate back out.
Yeah, means I can focus on raw damage this turn.
From the golem. We can't defeat it while it contains such power.
Oh, we have to drain its source.
Okay, so you're gonna have to jump in there and vamp it.
Yep. Hang on. Does that mean... Draco?
What?
I want you on your turn to try Source Vampirism on the other one.
Oh, you mean Source Vamp it before it actually...
Before it gets... Maybe if we... Because these things are source powers, so if we drain it of its source... Do my wings have fortune? Expired now.
What about your tactical retreat?
Gonna right here.
Drain.
So
yeah, on my turn, I'll try it on the other one. If we source vamp it, does that make it so it's inactive permanently?
That case, I'm just gonna... It's a bit hard to target.
No, it's telling me invalid target right now. I guess really? It has to be in that state in order to actually do it.
Dang. Oh, well. We have more than enough actions before to finish it off and get it into its inactive state.
Oh yeah, especially after I do this. Bonk!
There you go. Oh, the fight's technically over, so...
Done.
Okay, well, that's 2 out of 3 down.
Yeah, that is 2 out of 3 down.
How about we go take out the last one, and that would be perfect time for the break.
Yep, sounds like a good time. Oh, that was a doozy.
That was well fought. Only one casualty during it.
Scroll of Eternity?
Ooh, my. Also, there are 3 buttons.
Scroll details. This scroll deals with some arcane science referred to as Aladricus physics, which is completely impossible to understand from either the printed text or scribbled notes in the margins. The copious wine stains don't help with the comprehension either.
Nice.
Hang on a minute. Aren't Fane's people known as the Eternals?
Yes, why?
Maybe he knows about it.
Oh. Hey, Fane, read the thing that I just picked up. Nope, still the same thing.
Darn. Okay, so the last one is strutting about over there. I'm gonna go here.
And I think that one's actually also going into the back as well.
Yeah. Where is it?
I hear it.
There it is. Bought it.
It is Harbringer.
So
it is Warfare Era. Okay, it's not like the Warbringer. So back it up. I'm gonna back myself up and out of here. I wish there was a better way of getting source.
Yeah, running out of sources.
At least now we only have the one left. And you could actually have some height advantage here too.
Yep.
All right, let's take do you want to kill it or do you want to take our lunch break now?
Kill it, then have our lunch break, but first drop a save.
Oh yeah, of course. Always drop a save. So I'm going to move Fane up there.
It's a convenient blood spot. Use two. Oh.
What?
These are the paintings from the introduction scene.
Really?
Yeah, like when you select single player, these are the paintings that show up.
Yeah. I don't think that'll
I found a dwarven thief.
Also, I can't help but notice there are like source sparkles by that door.
And you thought Rivelon was flat?
Alright, are we ready to aggro it?
Yep.
I'll aggro it as myself.
Oh wait, this blood's... Oh, are you serious? This blood spot here is not valid. Wait.
Oh, hold on. Seems you're not in the fight yet. So I'll just do this. Oh. Okay, so that put Fane in the fight.
Yeah, for me getting blood will put me in the fight too. But I'll start off with the blood arrows.
Yep, yours will. So first thing I'm gonna do. Have some oil, buddy. And then have some more oil.
Oh boy. That took up its AP, but okay, we do not want to get hit by it now.
No, we don't. At least it's only one turn.
Time to make him all wet.
Slowly but surely.
I think this one only has 2,000 shielding.
4,000.
Oh no, it was looking at the champion.
Incarnate, I know. With how big the incarnates are, it's kind of crazy.
Come on. It's not actually selecting him. There.
Do the overhead view if you have an issue.
Yeah, I am in the overhead view.
excuse me. At least he can't cast a spell right now.
Mm.
Alright, start beating him up there, Midnight, with your incarnate. The Cup of Kings. And you may want to put yourself into combat as well. Before your incarnate finishes this turn.
Yeah, that way you still get a hit in.
Sneak into range and get yourself a totem down. Oh, just putting down one will do it. Nice. And guess what? You probably get to put down another one.
It's gonna lessen how many arrows I shoot, but I may as well just to get more damage in.
Oily blob. Guess what is gonna be about ready to come around us around this area? A lot of oil.
America would like to know your location.
Yeah, so he has the ability to turn to oil, which literally turns water and blood surfaces into oil.
Oh, cool.
When I say, let there be oil, there's oil.
Fresh incarnate. Magic armor is gone.
Glory is mine.
Okay. Whoops.
It's okay. That was from a scroll anyways.
I can fuse it again.
I'm literally just like throwing random stuff at it.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's wet now.
Honestly, I think the oil toads in the currents will finish him off.
I think all that will do it. We just got to make sure that we get somebody in close enough to
Oh yeah, you get three turns before it stands back up. And it should be either you or Fane, so that he can restock on your source a bit.
I will need one of those two.
Glory is mine.
That'll do. It's just walking. What's it doing?
It's broken.
There you go.
I got it in time. Whew. That was gonna be deadly if it that actually like somehow just came back to haunt us.
Yeah. Ooh, we got some golden plates and stuff here. I mean, loot all
I wanted to
fine.
See this cup of kings. Where's this cup of kings? A simple cut, slightly rusted and stained with wine. Six new recipes, nice. Don't mind me, I'm clearing out our oil problem.
Alright, time for some food.
Yeah, it's definitely time for some food. But I'm looting.
Well, I'm gonna go and grab my food.
What's this? I found something.
You didn't find something. You knew it was there the entire time.
You see yourself in the mirror. It's quite a sight.
It's locked, but there's no keyhole or handle. There's got to be some way to open it, though.
The ghost looks around the room with an incredulous shake of his head and fixates on the set of paintings before him.
What a fool I've been. Thieving was the best chance I had of keeping afloat in this wretched city. Never thought that would mean trying to impress a band of urchins, let alone getting crushed by a damn golem. Big Tomorrow said they'd let me in their grubby little guild if I helped them nab that painting of Kem's, the second Passion of Lucian. Well, we made it in all right. And while Kem's constructs tore me to shreds, they all ran off with a painting. If you don't know her, it's best to keep it that way. That thieves' guild of hers is a cutthroat bunch of young'uns.
Oh, there's a spirit.
The
painting.
Spirit of a painting hovers where the painting itself once stood. The second Passion of Lucian, you presume. The memory comes to you. Deep underground, in the home of the children and the trolls, sits the painting that completes the triptych. It's difficult to see the image as it must appear in the real world. This, perhaps, is the moment where Lucian killed Damien and sacrificed himself for the world. The spirit of a painting hovers where the painting... The mem... It's difficult to...
Okay.
Interesting.
So...
And I guess that's how we open that door.
Yeah, so we need the painting. Sorry, archaeologist. I'm sick and tired of seeing you around here. So we have to go to the Thieves Guild in order to steal it?
Yeah, the girl and her trolls.
That's true. Hey there. Whoops, I hit the wrong button.
What do you do?
I hit my button for hate raids.
Oops.
Yep, give me a second. Gotta turn off follower mode. Sorry about that. There we go. Yeah, I have a button for that.
Alright.
How are you doing there, Wicked Mistress? It's been a long time. Yeah, it's been still fun, though. So it's the kids and our trolls. Okay, so we gotta go see them for the painting, then.
Yep.
And speaking of paintings... There are a lot of paintings in here for some money, money, money. So they were in the sewers, right?
Yep.
Oh, Midnight, I sent you a hat that I found. So what have you been up to, Miss Wicked Mistress?
It's a bit better than what I had. Okay.
Ooh, I identified two-handed sword. Take that two-handed sword, much better than my axe I currently have.
Oh my.
What'd you find? Another secret entrance. Oh. Portrait of the Divine.
It's even like the name is in gold.
This painting is spectacular in its ugliness.
No,
good find.
Yoink!
Just about to comment on the fact that how the baby in there looks very demonic because it's red skin, glowy eyes.
I wonder then.
It's got like six horns.
Again, I wonder. Alrighty then, so to the sewers?
Before we do that, let's actually explore the mansion a bit more, shall we? Sure. We like rushed right into here.
Well, we were like, hey, we have a way in here now. Let's go check this out. Pizza and watching me, I like that. I will actually be right back. I'm gonna go warm up my food.
Yeah, sounds good. I just got my food, so.
Yeah, I'm just gonna warm it up. I'll bring it right back. Not gonna be long.
The water rises and falls. On Lord Ken's command,